today, and tomorrow our church celebrates two very famous Johns. Today, Sunday, November 12th, is the feast day of St. John the Merciful, who was the Patriarch of Alexandria in Egypt. Tomorrow is the feast day of St. John Chrysostom, who is credited with authoring the divine liturgy we celebrate every Sunday and every time we have a liturgy. I wanted to speak a little bit, though, about St. John the Merciful. Can anyone here tell me what the word mercy means? We hear it a lot in church, right? Because we always hear the choir, people say, Lord have mercy, right? Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Kyrie eleison. We hear the word mercy. What does mercy mean? What do you think it means? Can I give you a hint? Okay. There's a word that starts with L. So love, the word mercy is best translated, really, and it's not even an accurate translation, but it means some kind of very deep and passionate love. The love that we're supposed to have for each other, for Christians, for non-Christians, for men and women, for young people and old people, for people we know, people we don't know. And this morning, as I mentioned, our church celebrates, if you look here on the calendar, November 12th, here we are, St. John the Merciful. So St. John is called, he's given the title the Merciful. Not many saints, hardly any saint, is given the title Merciful. The title Merciful is referred usually to Christ only, not to a saint. But St. John is called the Merciful because he was full of love. He was full of love to the people that he took care of, because he was a bishop of the church. He was the patriarch, that's the highest ranking bishop in a particular area, the diocese, kind of like the Pope. He was the highest ranking bishop in Alexandria. Now, to give you a little bit of insight into Alexandria, we've heard that name before, I know. So it was, back in those days, kind of like the New York City of America. It was one of the most, probably the most populated city in all of the Mediterranean world. Hundreds of thousands of people lived in the city, and it was multicultural. So you had many people who were Egyptian living there, you had many Greeks who were living there, you had many people from other parts of the Middle East who lived there. It was multicultural, and people spoke a lot of languages. But like every place in the world, there was a lot of poverty, and there was a lot of suffering, as you can imagine. So St. John, being this bishop, had a very special place in his heart for helping people and listening to their problems. That was kind of the thing he did more than anything else. And he established many hospitals, many orphanages, and he gave money away, and he gave most especially his time to people to listen to them. So I'm going to tell you a story from his life. I think most of you have, maybe some of you, or most of you maybe have heard this story before, but I'm going to tell it to you anyway, again. So one day, it was a Sunday, just like today's. And what does a bishop do on Sunday? He doesn't play golf. What does a bishop do? Prayer. He goes to church, like we're in church now, right? He celebrates the liturgy. So he was on his way, he was walking to the big church in Alexandria where he was going to celebrate the liturgy of the cathedral. Well, as he was walking, an old woman comes up to him and says to him, Bishop John, I need to talk to you. And he said, what is it, daughter? And he said, I need to talk to you because I have these problems and I just need you to help me, please. I just need someone to listen to me. No one can help me and I need your prayers. And so, keep in mind, he was on his way to church, so he was going to probably be running late if he stayed with this woman. So he said, okay. He sat down on the side there, and the woman started talking with him. And she talked, and he listened. And she talked, and he listened. And he talked, and she listened. And the next thing you know, 2 hours went by. 2 hours went by. He was late for church. 2 hours. Can you imagine if I was late for church 2 hours? Right? Same thing. The bishop was late for church 2 hours. Finally, he helped her. He spoke to her. He hugged her. He gave her money, whatever he had on him at the time. And he prayed for her. And she went away with a renewed faith in Christ, with great hope and joy that someone cared about her, that someone showed her mercy, love, like we said the word love. When he finally got to church, the other bishops who were there, and the other priests who were there, they came up to him and they said, "Patriarch John, what happened to you? We had to start the service. We couldn't wait 2 hours. We're so sorry, but we had to start the service." And you know, you can't start the service without the bishop, right? The highest bishop. "We had to start the service. We couldn't wait for you anymore. People were getting impatient. And we thought something happened to you. We thought someone robbed you or hurt you." And he said, "No," he said, "I'm fine." And he apologized for being late, but he said, "I was actually celebrating the liturgy also." And they looked at him and they said, "What do you mean you were celebrating the liturgy? The liturgy is here. You're supposed to lead us here in the liturgy here in the cathedral, in the church." And he said, "No. I was celebrating the liturgy because I offered a sacrifice of love on another altar." And they looked at him and they said, "What altar are you talking about? The altar's right here." He said, "No. I offered the sacrifice of love on the altar of another human heart that needed me." He said, and then when he vested, the liturgy had already started, he simply received communion and then he came out and he spoke to the people. And he said, "We must remember that the reason we have a liturgy is because Christ sacrificed out of love for the people, for the world to save us. That love is what gave us a service to celebrate. That is what we do when we celebrate the Eucharist on Sunday. And that liturgy does not only take place in the building of the church, but it also has to continue outside of the church. So when people need us, we also have to spend time with them. We have to show them mercy, not only in church when we're supposed to be good and don't talk and pray and all that. This liturgy is the model. What we have here in these 2 hours that we're in church, this is a model for how life is supposed to be out there. What we have here is our time with God. And when we leave our time with God here, then we go out there to share our time with God with others who can't be in church or who aren't in church. So we're always offering a sacrifice of love, mercy to one another through what we learn from here. That's what I wanted to share with you this morning. So the divine liturgy that we celebrate happens in the building of the church, but it actually continues when we leave the church because we are offering this love to others. So the word mercy, eleos in Greek, we hear kyrieleison all the time, it means love. But it doesn't mean love like, "Oh, I love you," like an emotion. It doesn't mean that at all. Anything but that. Mercy means to see life through the eyes of the other person. It means to feel their pain more than they do. It means to give them time so that they can be healed. It means almost to exchange your life with theirs. And although that sounds kind of impossible to do, we can still do this by giving people time. All people want is to be understood. They may want other things too. They know we can't give them other things, like if they need $1 million, they know we can't give them $1 million. Or there are certain things we can do, but all people need love. And all people need time, our time. And that time that we spend is not the time that once something starts and another thing ends. That time is called keros, God's time. There are two kinds of time. There's a time, historical time, something begins and ends, it's like liturgy in the church begins at this time and ends at another time. But it's keros, it's giving people God in God's time. That's something we'll talk about at another opportunity. But that's what I wanted to share with you this morning. So let us remember always that the liturgy that we celebrate is not only begins and ends here, it continues outside. And we are always to give this mercy and love to all those people in the world who need it. This applies to all of us seated here in the church and all Christians everywhere. So we celebrate St. John the Merciful. He gives us this example. Let's try to follow this example of giving people our time and thus giving them our love.